on your follow through, you just want it to be straight on and hold it, because a lot of times we'll just shoot it and then let it go and the ball ends up going left or right. So when we shoot it, we focus a lot on after just holding it. And we just say, like, grabbing a cookie out of the cookie jar, that's what we say. And so that's just kind of a good tip for us, and we always do it.
Yeah, so, I don't know, I like to keep my, I like to keep the ball on the right side of my head. I don't want it to get too in front of my face or anything like that. That way I can shoot straight towards the rim. And I just bring my guide hand up and I follow straight through with my guide hand. And I keep my guide hand on it at all times. But then at the last second, I just like slightly release and then make sure my guide hand doesn't go like this. It just stays right here and follow through.
Making sure that the ball doesn't come off these fingers, not so it doesn't get like a weird side spin and comes off the first two fingers.
If I'm off the ball, I like to, you know, stay low, get my hands up, be ready for the pass so they can deliver it right to my shooter's pocket. So when they pass to me, I like to step in it, right, left, or left, right, depending on which way the ball's coming from. And then from there, it's easier just to rise and elevate into your shot.
Like shoulder width apart. I bend my legs a little bit. Then I just use the power from my legs.
Yeah, so a lot of times we have to be ready for the pass, because if you're standing straight up, you're not going to be able to get the shot up there. So we like to get low, and once you get it, be ready to shoot. And also a big thing is, after you shoot and jump, we like to land with our feet in the same spot, because if you move to the side, then it's off balance and doesn't work. So that's another